storms to the east, blowing dust out to the west. It is going to be one of those days where certainly the wind is going to be quite strong out there this afternoon. This is the latest right now with our severe weather, a tornado watch in eastern Oklahoma. Now, we don't have any threat for severe weather here in Oklahoma City, but again, this tornado watch and severe thunderstorm warnings within this tornado watch. And again, as we look at Advantage Doppler 3D right now, all is fairly quiet across central Oklahoma, but we're starting to see those storms continue to develop, move up to the northeast, and they're going to be dealing with severe weather for the next couple hours. Now, we do have our crews in eastern Oklahoma right now. Chance Cold Iron, he is near Panama, Oklahoma here, looking at the storms in the distance. Certainly, yeah, you can see they've had a little bit more rain in eastern Oklahoma than we have seen in western Oklahoma. The grass is green, the trees have plenty of leaves on, but we need to see a lot more rain in the days ahead. All right, let's talk about what's happening right here in Oklahoma City, because again, that blowing dust, you can see it here. It's that, yeah, certainly that reduced visibility. You can barely see the Devon Tower there in the distance, and this blowing dust advisory that we have in effect will remain in effect until 8 p.m. It does include all of western Oklahoma here, as we're going to have that blowing dust and those strong winds just reducing visibility. Right now, winds are gusting 40 to almost 50 miles per hour in western Oklahoma, coming in from the southwest. So that's just pulling in all that dirt out of the Texas panhandle. But look at this picture right here on this date last year, and just look at how green Oklahoma was here. I mean, we were dealing with lots of rain, so certainly we had plenty of green vegetation out there. Here's Canton Lake, here's Lawton, here is Oklahoma City. Now look at the same image today and notice how it's not as green. So that's why we really need to get the rainfall in here. And we're still dealing with that drought. It is certainly pretty nasty out in western Oklahoma. We only have one chance of rain this week, and it comes in here for tomorrow. So lows tonight, it'll be a cool night, 40s and 50s. What can you expect as you're driving into work tomorrow morning? You'll need a light jacket at 7 a.m. Temperatures in the 50s by 8 a.m. Nice, 59 degrees. And by 9 a.m., sunglasses, temperatures in the lower 60s. And those winds up around 10 and 20 miles per hour. So a cool night tonight as we get down to 53 degrees, 59 at 8 a.m. It will be a breezy afternoon tomorrow. Those winds up around 15 to 25 miles per hour. But we do have a chance of rain. It is the only chance of rain that we have for the entire week here across central Oklahoma at a 30% chance. So 30% chance of rain for Oklahoma City, 20% chance of rain in Enid and in Ponca City. No threat for severe weather as we go into the day tomorrow. Highs across the state, low to mid 70s, 75 degrees in Oklahoma City, 76 in Seminole, 75 in Stillwater here. As we look at the temperature trend this week, temperatures are going to stay below normal. Our average high is about 76 degrees. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, temperatures are going to stay about 10 degrees below normal. They start climbing, though, as we head into the weekend. So the headlines for this week, below normal temperatures expected throughout the entire week, dry after Tuesday. So good car washing weather, but certainly we will have some chilly mornings. Well, make sure you grab the jacket. And again, the severe weather risks this week, we are not looking at any threat for severe weather at all this week for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday here. So your 7-day forecast, again, only a 30% chance of showers for tomorrow afternoon. Very light rainfall during the day, 75 degrees. Otherwise, it'll be cool for Tuesday, only 63, 62 on Wednesday. And as we roll into the month of May, temperatures begin to climb into the 60s, 70s, and then we're back into the 80s 1 week from today. And you're up to date with the latest First Alert forecast.